American Airlines now planning to sell basic economy seats to its entire domestic network by the end of September. Basic economy tickets are not actually lower price, they are just a new lowest fare with severe restrictions. So the seats are normally in the back of the plane, often in the middle. The tickets cannot be changed or refunded, and some airlines won't even let you use the overhead bins. United and Delta have already been selling basic economy seats on all of their domestic flights, so what can we do about it? Edward Pizzarello is here. He's a travel blogger and editor of Pizza in Motion. So break it down for us. What does this mean for the next time someone goes to buy a plane ticket on American? How does this work?
Good to be back with you, Arthel. I think the thing to consider here is they're going to see a lot more options when they try and buy that cheapest seat. The airlines are going to do a great job disclosing what they don't get, and as you mentioned, things like you won't get a seat assignment until either very close to the flight or right there at the gate. But what's important to know is if you're not booking through the airline's website, sites like Expedia might not show you all the things you're not getting, so it might be a little unclear what sort of fare you're buying.
I see. So, you know, there are some people who say, look, if I'm going to get a discount, I don't care if I sit in the middle seat, or I don't care if I'm in the back of the plane, and oh, I don't need to use the overhead bin. So this might be a good thing for some travelers. What prompted this? What does American Airlines have to gain?
Well, they all have extra revenue to gain. They see this as a way to get customers to buy up from the cheapest fares. They've been matching the cheap fares of Southwest, JetBlue, Spirit, and Frontier for a while. So if you do want to save money, but you don't want to get stuck in the middle seat, the better bet might be to look at Southwest or Frontier.
Okay, but getting back to this, what we started talking about, these seats that American's offering, you said it's better if you go directly to American's website, American Airlines website, to get these deals. And how does it work? Again, I mean, so do I save money?
Well, you'll save money over the more expensive fares. These are the same fares they were a few months ago, the same lowest fares. What you're saying is, in exchange for not being able to pick your seat, mm-hmm. in exchange for not being able to bring a full-size carry-on on board, you know, you can save $20 to $30 per flight, if you will, per round-trip ticket.
Mm-hmm. So Delta and United, they already made these changes that you're talking about. How's it working for those airlines?
Well, it's working a little differently for both. Delta will actually let you bring a carry-on bag on board along with your personal item. So they're each approaching it a little bit differently. Delta's rolled it out system-wide and continues to grow with it. United has rolled it out. They're not thrilled with the initial results, but I think the big thing here is that you know, the customer needs to figure out exactly what's important to them. If you want to bring a bag on board, you may want to consider either making sure that you have the airline's credit card, or you might want to choose, say, Delta over American, who's going to let you bring that carry-on bag on board without a fee.
Mm-hmm. And back to American, do the new changes apply only to domestic flights?
Well, for now they do. They also have it rolled out in a few Canadian markets. You know, I would guess that we'll start to see this on international flights there as well, because Delta started playing around with that for a little while now. But I think what you'll see is it's going to be on all domestic flights, a handful of Canadian flights for the moment. And then I think the airlines will take a few months to figure out how it's doing, and then we may see this stuff come out internationally next year.
Would you take advantage of this? Save $20 for a flight and you sit in the middle and you can't bring stuff on the plane, you know, you can't bring your bag, but no, use the overhead bin?
Toughest part for me as a business traveler is those tickets also don't let you change. And you know, with plans changing so frequently, if there's a mechanical delay or a weather delay, American Airlines specifically says if one of those things happens, they're not going to move you to another airline. And I think it's important to get to where you're going. So I think you have to really weigh what's most important when you want to save that $20.
I hear that. Pizza in Motion, is that your blog?
It is. Good to be with you again.
Pizza in Motion. Okay. I'll check it out. Thank you. Take care.
Thanks, Arthel.
Mm-hmm.